Merriment.
Survival for expats.
In the concrete forest.
On Friday night.
Hi guys, and welcome to You Can't Sit With Us, the weekly show where we get wasted.
She is.
Hey, my name is Ali Bongo, and this is...
Cassie.
No.
This is Hot Commodity.
Hot Commodity. That's what I'm like, that should be your new nickname, Hot Cod.
Hot Cod.
Yeah.
Sounds like a really weird fish and chips.
Or be Hot Com, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Hot Com.
Hot Cod. I'm like trying to... I know what's wrong. We're sitting in the wrong seats.
I think, no, that's because we've been sat with this. I think it's the angle. Maybe it's a weird.
I don't know. What's going on?
I like these leggings.
Thanks,
like,
man.
Textured. They're
dusty. Like my soul.
Like my. What's that?
Like your vagina.
Like my
vagina. Vagina.
Oh, hi, Jim.
Oh, hi, Jim Bond. Thank you very much.
And happy Friday to you, too. Who cares that it's Ali's birthday? We've been celebrating for, like, the last 4 days.
I'm actually almost kind of sick of my birthday now. Because originally, I was supposed to go to Thailand tonight for the weekend. So I was like, okay, I'll have my birthday celebrations last weekend. So I did. We went out for brunch, and it was awesome.
No, we didn't just go for brunch. We went for brunch. Then we went to more bars.
And more bars.
And then more bars. And more bars. And I got home at like 2 a.m. So we was like a good...
Yeah.
Good like 15 hours of like solid drinking.
And I was out a little bit longer than... I think I got home at like 3 or 4.
I went home because I felt sick. Like, I was like, oh, I need to go home.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I thought Gavin made you go home.
No, I was like, I want to go home. And he was like, oh, I want to stay. And I was like, okay, well, you're taking me home first. So he took me home and then he came back out.
Big dumb hat.
And his big dumb hat, Star Wars hat.
Yeah, and then on Wednesday we were doing an event for Bloomy. And that just rolled into the night for midnight for my actual birthday.
We had champagne
for everyone.
And then we were out until 7 a.m.
Yeah, and then we went for a meal yesterday. So I'm kind of over my birthday now. Like, people are like, oh, but you can have your birthday weekend this week. And I was like, I don't want it. I'm bored of my birthday now. I'm like, I'm 25.
How
like, chill out.
How dare you be bored of your birthday? On my birthday, I celebrate the entire month of September, by the way, in case anyone didn't know when my birthday was. Yeah.
I look really, really white today.
I'm always
like,
really,
as if
really
as if
white.
I needed, like, more encouragement.
Hello. Oh. Ah! What is
Happy
this?
What?
Wow!
From you?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
This is the most beautiful flowers ever. Oh my god.
I've never had flowers before. This is the
Is it from an admirer? A secret admirer? It's from me.
Oh my god, it's from Jen Bond.
Jen Bond.
Jen Bond, that's so nice.
What the fuck? I was going to get Ali flowers for her birthday because she'd never gotten flowers before.
They're so nice. Look at these little...
How did you get them here from New York?
Oh yeah, how did that happen?
Mysterious. That's amazing.
Oh, that's so nice.
Thank you so much, Jen Bond. I don't know what to say. I know it's Ali's birthday, so this is kind of awkward, but it's really nice of you to get me flowers. I'm feeling very touched, and I mean, Ali, I'm really sorry that nobody got you anything.
Oh my gosh. I'm like, verge of tears, like, so happy. That's
don't
so
cry.
Nice.
That's
I'm not
so
gonna
gay.
Cry.
That's so, what are these berries for? Can we eat those?
I think they're cranberries, right?
Drugs! They're hallucinogens. I dare you to eat
hallucinacacid.
That's okay. Anyway, thanks, Jen Bond, for my flowers. What does it say?
It says, happy birthday, Ali Bongo, from your devoted fans, love heart, Jen Bond, NYUSA.
Oh, what is this phone is not ours. This is somebody's phone. Somebody come get your phone.
Should we answer it?
Hello.
Wait. They hung up.
So we have somebody's phone in here, and Ali just tried to... Oh, that's really sweet, Jen Bond. I just want to ask one question. Where are my flowers on my birthday? I didn't get any.
Is this your phone?
You have got to come and get it.
Naughty boy,
walk of shame. Shame on you.
I could hear him from like the back office going like... Wah!
We love to strike fear into the heart of our staff members. We
like to like build them up, make them think that we love them, and scare them.
By the way, Abby will be joining us later, but now she can't sit here because the flowers have taken pride of place.
Abby's sitting on the floor tonight.
I'm like, with not even regrets. I'm not even gonna be like, oh, sorry, Abby. I'm like, sorry, Abby, you don't get to sit here.
Yeah, you can't sit with us. Flowers can sit with us though. Gosh, that's amazing.
Yeah, this is so nice too. My God,
Garen's gonna step up his game for Valentine's Day. I'll be like, somebody who's never even met Ali got her flowers that big. I better get like 99 roses.
Oh my gosh. Ooh, I'm gonna count them later. Oh my gosh.
She's gonna count them later. And if I get less for Valentine's Day, she's gonna give me so much shit.
Yes.
But then you're not gonna get any for Valentine's Day. So I'll be like, where are your Valentine's Day flowers?
Thank you. You're gonna get me some.
That's true. I'm not going to get them on Valentine's Day because I'm not spending $1,000 on a bouquet of roses for you.
No. We should do it on the 18th. Be like, what? People do it on the 15th too. We're rogue.
We're rogue.
Rogue as fuck.
Well, Garen and I do 15th.
That's cute.
Because Valentine's Day is commercial bullshit. No, because Garen booked a comedy show last Valentine's Day and I was furious with him. So angry.
I think my hair looks really good today. I'm really impressed, but I actually haven't done anything to it.
My hair looks like a disaster as usual.
Disaster.
Because I am a disaster.
It reflects your life.
It really does.
And your life choices.
Well, actually, I don't know if you know this, but I'm going to be a big-time insurance agent.
Oh, my God. Have you heard this? By the way, everybody, Cassie has got a real-life job and is going to be an insurance agent.
Can you imagine me trying to sell insurance? Hi. Ever worried that you're going to injure yourself while drinking? I do all the time. Buy some insurance from me, your local friendly responsible person.
Yeah. I can help you make good life choices.
I'll like try and sell Ali insurance when she's drunk and like get her to like sign away like large amounts of money.
Oh yeah, because I have large amounts of money to give away.
I'll put you into debt. I'll put you in like really high payments that you can't make, and then like there'll be more penalties and more penalties.
That's okay. I'll be like, Garen, as the third wheel in this relationship.
Can you pay my insurance payments?
Yeah. I mean, we're slowly getting there. He bought Cassie's Christmas present for me.
That's true.
I was like, Garen, I want to get Cassie this for Christmas. Can you buy it? And he went, yeah, okay.
It's working.
Slowly, like, creeping into the third wheel.
Creeping into the relationship.
And then I'm going
to,
like...
You're coming to Macau with us.
Yeah, I'm gonna move him away from the relationship. He's just there for financial beneficiary reasons.
Great.
Yeah.
It's really good. Good job.
And then we just get to get drunk and like make out all the time. It's awesome.
Awesome. Awesome. I'm really like disturbed about what my hair is doing right now. Should I tie it up?
Yeah, you look cute tied up.
I know how to tie my hair up.
This is an event worth watching. She slowly gathers.
Shut up.
Is that really how you think you tie your hair up?
No, I know how to do it. Okay, shut up.
I've seen it on YouTube before.
I actually did look up a YouTube tutorial. But it was all like, how to braid your hair. There we go. What's that? What's that, Ali Bongo? You want to make fun of me now?
Huh? I want to make fun of you always. You look so cute with your hair up. Like, young.
I am young. Not old like you, Bongo.
You are 9 months younger than me.
Yeah, well, exactly. Stunning!
Beautiful!
Beautiful! Now you can see my titties.
See the titties.
Titties.
I'm very reserved now. I'm like, I'm 25. Look how reserved and
I don't own a skirt that long. When I went for my job interview, I was like, how appropriate.
It's very long.
Yeah.
It's like below knee length.
So then. I'm wearing trousers. Yeah, fashion. Ugh.
And then, like,
my boobs look good here, and then my boobs don't look good here, and then they look... I understand what's going on. It's the lighting.
But can you do it one more time? Yeah. And then back. And then forward again. And then back.
This is what our like show has been reduced to, just like titties.
Reduced to? As if it was so highbrow before.
What it always was.
That's it's okay, we've gained one more follower.
That's good. We have one more viewer thanks to titties. I don't know what my hair is doing.
How does it make you feel that your titties only gained one more viewer?
Listen, your titties, we're gonna lose viewers.
They'd be like, are you trans? Have you had the op yet?
Oh, Bongo.
It's okay. Small titties are okay too.
Small titties are great. Okay, I'm going to take my hair down.
I'm wearing my nice bra. Oh, yeah, and I'm wearing... Oh, no,
are
no.
you wearing your sexy new bra that you sent me pictures of?
No. I tried to, but it takes so long to like do up. It's got like 17,000 hooks.
I've got one. It's got like five.
No, it's got like at least seven.
At least 7 hooks. Yeah, I don't like being on this side of the camera. Can we swap at commercial break?
No.
I don't like
this is
side.
My good side. This is my good side.
This is my
look,
bad
look
side.
Look at how terrible I look from this side.
You look way better from that side.
No, it's not true. It's not true.
This isn't going to work because we both have the same good side.
But you've been on that side for ages.
Have I?
Yes.
This is some racist bullshit. I don't know why it's racist, but I'm just deciding.
Because we're
it was.
Both white.
Race. Race politics. That's what we're talking about today.
That sounds like an excellent thing.
No, well, we had some ideas of what we wanted to do. We literally gone like 10 minutes talking about nothing. So we did have some ideas of what we did want to talk
about.
Opposed
to our usual hour. That is not good wine. Ugh.
We wanted to talk about Arowana's employer being bullied in jail.
Wow, I beat my maid up so she was almost dead and then I went to jail and people were mean to me.
And I think that's great. That gives me a lot more respect for the Hong Kong criminal classes. Discerning enough to be like, oh, we've done some shitty stuff, but like, fuck this woman in particular because she is a fucking monster.
But like, we didn't beat our maids. We just sold drugs and killed people.
Exactly. At least they had like the goal to finish the job.
But she was doing it for, like, power and kicks and giggles. Some people kill people by mistake.
And also kill people because they kind of deserved it.
Yeah.
In defense. There's a lot of people I'd like to kill.
Or just...
No, just, like, full up, straight up murder.
What are you doing tomorrow?
Why? You want me to murder someone?
No, should we go to that that set lunch place?
Which one?
Something... The Chinese place.
Oh, monogamous Chinese.
Yeah.
I like how we're just like now just making weekend plans. Cause fuck it. Yes.
Because we're really interested. Oh, we lost almost 10, more than 10 viewers.
Uh-oh,
SpaghettiO. So obviously... It's almost like we care.
Uh-oh.
I think we should try and do a Leah-inspired show one day. So Leah is a Hong Kong comedian, we'll use that term.
She's not a comedian, she's an open micer.
Yeah, she's a Hong Kong open micer. And sometimes I find it really hilarious, but only when other people tell me the stories about her comedy sets. When you actually watch it, you're like, oh my fucking God, like, is it the end of time?
And then Ali starts, like, taking up smoking. She's like, well, let's go out for a cigarette.
Like, I don't smoke, I hate smoking, but when she's on stage, fucking hell, I need something. Like... cyanide,
arsenic,
all those things that can be found in cigarettes. So I need it. But this one time she got on stage, just started eating like a peanut butter sandwich. She was like, does anyone want some? Too late.
And then she was like, and then this guy in the audience was like, I want some. She's like, come up on stage. And then he like is walking to the stage. She's just like, and like eats it all. She's like, too late. I think that's hilarious. I want to do that in my next time. Like, does anyone want this handful of ecstasy? Too late. I like how you flinched when I was taking pills. You were like, no, not the pills in case one lands.
Do you think people can see if I flinch?
Yeah, obviously. I just watched as that
explained. All right.
That was cool.
Okay, guys, we are going to go from a commercial break. Stay tuned for some more awesome super fun.
Bye-bye, commercial break, bye-bye.
That was a really good Velociraptor impression.
And no one's taking us to commercial break. Now I'm a T-Rex.
This is my Velociraptor drowning noise. Oh, I didn't see you there.
I'm Cassie.
And I'm Ali Bonga, and we are the hosts of You Can't Sit With Us, the weekly show where we get wasted. We go live on Friday nights on lojo.com at 8 p.m. So don't forget to subscribe on Lojoke.
Mwah! We love you.
We love you. Bye.
Bye.